Hello everyone, welcome to Beaver's Hobby Channel. This is a review of TS100 Soldering Iron. If you are into RC hobby, sooner or later, you are going to have to do some soldering. A good soldering iron will make your life much easier. Banggood has sent me this Flipsky SQ001. It is actually another variation of the TS100, which is a very good iron. Now, let's open it up. Inside the package, we have the iron. This is a programmable iron with adjustable temperature. It runs on 12 to 24 volt, and most importantly, it feels light and pretty comfortable to hold. Next is the tip. This is knife tip, which is pretty useful, but I don't use it very much. Fortunately, it is interchangeable, so you can choose the tip according to the job you are going to do. Here I have conical tips to use because I am more familiar with this type. There are also chisel and concave, which are very useful. Put the tip in like this. It is pretty tight in here, so it will work even without a screw, but let's tighten it down anyway. And don't forget to loosen the screw when you change the tip. Next, we have the power cable with barrel connector for the iron and XT60 connector for the power source. This is a great addition to the package because the other TS100 don't give you this cable and you'll have to buy it extra. However, it does not include power source, so you'll have to provide your own power supply or battery. I only have 12 volt power supply, so let's see how this works. Later, I'll also see how it works with 3S LiPo battery, which will be my field setup. Next, we have the stand with a sponge, a manual, a safety instruction, and spare screws with Allen key. Let's check the temperature. It doesn't quite reach the temperature with original firmware, so I'm gonna update it with the open source firmware from GitHub. Link is in the description below. Here's how to update the firmware. You'll need a computer to do this. Hold the air button and plug the micro USB in. It'll show up as a flash drive. Now put the .hex file in and wait. It will reconnect and the file will change from .hex to .rdy, which means ready. If it goes to .err, which means error, you should re-download the file and put it in again. And it is done. Plug the power supply in and wait. It has accelerometer inside to detect movement and orientation. And here you can see the screen rotates automatically. It heats up pretty quickly even on 12 volt input. As you can see, the temperature control is near perfect with this firmware. It has buttons and screen, so it looks pretty complicated, but it is actually intuitive to use. At the beginning, press A to start heating up the iron, or B to go into menu. Then press A to enter the menu and change the value. Basically, press A to adjust the setting and B to select the menu. To adjust the temperature, press A to go to temperature setting, then A or B to adjust the value. There are more features like sleep and shutdown. If you don't move it for a certain period of time, it'll go into sleep mode and cool down automatically. There's also low voltage cutoff for LiPo battery. Next, let's see how it actually works. I'm making an adapter to convert the DIN or T plug to XT60 so I can use my battery with this iron. I'm salvaging an old connector that I couldn't desolder the wires out before. Now I can pull them out with ease. Put the new wires in. And here it is, a job well done. Now let's try my fuel setup. The battery isn't fully charged, so we'll see how this goes. It is a bit slow to heat up, but it works. In conclusion, this is an excellent soldering iron that you can use anywhere, and I highly recommend it. It heats up quickly, and it holds the temperature really well. What set this package apart from other TS100 are the inclusion of the power cable and the knife tip. This package alone costs $45, but you may have to spend a little bit more on the tips you are going to use, and probably power supply. So, for a complete station, you are looking at around $70 for the iron, a tip, and a 24-volt power supply. I know it is a bit expensive, but really, everyone should have one of this. However, if this is too much for you, there's also a budget soldering iron that I have been using before I got this TS100. It costs $10, and it is perfect if you want to learn soldering without spending too much. And that's it for this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and hit the bell icon to get the notification whenever I upload a new video. You can follow me on Facebook or social media for quick updates, written reviews, news, and see what I'm doing between videos. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.